Yes, yes.
Yeah, you have to, like as you said, you have to move around your phone. And how would you perceive that AR or VR can be implemented in a very, in an actual way, rather than?
So our thinking, and we already are obviously doing R&D on this, and we know how to do this as a company. The future is a very, like glasses, pretty much, maybe more, a little more bulky than this, but not much more. And that is the future. So you just have your glasses and other people have their glasses. We've thought a lot about the interactions, the privacy issues that happened in the past, and how to make public by default so that people can actually see that I'm reading my own email right now and I'm not taking a picture of you or whatever it is that I'm doing, if I allow for it. But it would be nice if we are all kind of sharing and you know, being open and transparent, and so that way we can share and not feel isolated, but feel like we are all part of that digital reality and share it. So yes, I think that is going to come. Everybody will work. I know there's been research also in the contact lenses, and because of my experience that I've been with the team that was doing that, I know that there's a physical restriction. There's going to be, it's going to take a long time to leverage that to get beyond a few pixels. So that's why they were exploring the diabetes thing and not just bringing full screens. There's a physical limitation on what they can project being that close to the eye. So I don't expect that to be as fast as just the lenses. That's what I'm thinking for the information I have. Yes?
I thought your example that like microgravity smart was really cool.
The what, sorry?
I thought your example with the whiteboard gravity smart was really cool.
Yes.
But along with that, I was wondering what your thoughts on how necessary are tactile feedback in such interactions?
Well, that's really interesting. I think, we can argue that the whole of our sensorial experience is happening in our brain, and it's really a trick. It's a whole trick. So we believe we can trick the mind pretty much. So if you have digital objects, they respond to you in a way that has so much visual feedback and sound feedback, other kind of feedbacks, your brain will put it together and kind of make up for that tactile. You know how, you know, this is a study of perception and things like that. Eventually, yes, it's interesting that there are haptic gloves that could be working. I think those are more very interesting for VR, where you are not seeing your gloves and you're in your house. And as we move out into the world with AR, I think people, I mean, we might. But I don't see haptics as a core part of the short term. I think we believe that the visual feedback on all other senses together should make up for that. So that's why we have so much emphasis on neuroscience and UX experience. Our teams are really large, kind of thinking of these problems to avoid having to go to the gloves, which is something that we consider as well. Yes. You mean like these really strict glasses that your friend here was asking? We believe it could be 2 to 5 years, but obviously, you know, that might change. There might be early players, there might be late complications, so who knows? Yes?
Yeah, I have a question about creation in AR. So do you think it's going to continue to be with a keyboard, or are you guys experimenting with other ways, like actually physically writing something to create?
I see. We are not experimenting with that at this point. We're more interested in voice for now, and also having a virtual keyboard eventually. Those are things I see kind of more short term. And also because it's AR versus VR, we can have a physical keyboard right now. So our development kit that we're launching in early next year, it's more based on the actual physical keyboard. So because you can see it. So when you're in VR, because you have no sight at all, you pretty much, it's hard with a keyboard. You have to have the virtual keyboard. For us, the physical keyboard works pretty well as of today. Yes?
How do you think the Meta 2 compares against the HoloLens? And mm-hmm. Second is, how good is the gesture detection on the Meta 2?
How good is what detection?
The gesture detection.
Gesture. Okay. So we actually have a study open right now. I'll answer the last question first, but we actually have a a user study open right now. If you guys want to come and explore the where we are at and help us kind of leverage data for our machine learning to improve and computer vision algorithms to improve on our gestures, we are open and you can come and get a glimpse of what's happening. So you're welcome to do that. At the same time, I mean, obviously it's something we're working on. We hope to launch this pretty decent grab gesture, very solid gestures on at least a few of the interactions. We're constantly working to improve, but it's a new technology, so it has challenges, obviously. In regards to the comparison, in a way, we kind of have different probably publics and approaches to things, so we are thinking a lot more of that interaction. If you remember the first phone that Microsoft launched into the market, it was way before actually the iPhone, right? So Microsoft came out with Windows CE, and you could have a phone. I had a phone in 2003 that had Microsoft CE, but that phone didn't have any advantages, really. It had touch, but it was a very simple touch, and it was not really reinventing the interactions. It was just kind of porting. And I believe the Colo is kind of doing the same thing right now. It's just porting, because they are a larger platform, and they want to be compatible with every software that they ever built, and they have all this legacy behind them, they're really thinking on leveraging all that and just continue with the mouse and click paradigm. We really are thinking very differently. So that's, I think, the main difference. Other than that, on the hardware, both have strengths and weaknesses. We have a much larger field of view, about 90 degrees versus 45. That was one of the things that our users really wanted when we did Meta 1, so that's one of the things we learned. At the same time, they have much better segmentation, so you can put something on the walls and move it around all throughout the world. So we have not implemented that as of yet. So we are earlier, in a way, but we're more ambitious, I would say, so and thinking more deeply on how to reinvent the interface paradigm. Yes?
So to do occlusion, you need like a real-time 3D map of your environment. What tech are you using to achieve this?
So we're using depth sensors that are sending laser and kind of hearing back. It's PMD is the manufacturing, I believe, and it has a name. I can get back to you. I can't remember. It's the exact technology is VSEC or something like that. It's probably can't remember. But you can email me or tweet me, and I'll definitely get back to you on that with the exact technology. Okay. I think we're